All right, now we're going to turn to solar power. We've got a lot of environmental stories today. We're going to turn to Rebecca Smith from the Wall Street Journal. She is joining us from San Francisco about a new story about solar power plant that can actually produce power when the sun's not shining. This is quite an interesting concept, Rebecca. Tell us about this new plant.
Well, there's a plant proposed right now for Arizona. Abengoa is a big Spanish utility that's planning to build a plant out in Arizona that would be capable of storing heat in molten salt form overnight or during the day, and then it would release that heat later to make electricity. So this greatly improves the productivity of that power plant.
And what are some of the headwinds with this? Obviously, I believe cost is always sort of looked at as one of the stumbling blocks or hurdles, if you will, toward clean energy. Is that a factor here?
It's always a factor. I mean, especially with natural gas so inexpensive right now, it's very hard for renewable energy to compete. But in this case, you have utilities that are under orders from a state to buy more renewable power. So they're very keen, particularly in the desert Southwest, to increase the amount of solar power. So there's this one plant in Arizona by Abengoa. They're building a similar one in California. And then there are several more on the horizon coming along in the 2013-2014 timeframe.
And I understand that the storage of this electricity is sort of a unique factor in this plant. Explain to us why it is so unique and what they're doing.
Well, they're going to be taking some of the heat from the solar plant during the day, and they're going to be putting that heat into this salt storage, which is, it really isn't a whole lot more complicated than it sounds. It's vast tanks of salt, and when they're heated up to around 500 degrees Fahrenheit, they become molten. And they can increase the heat anywhere from 500 to 1,000 degrees. It will hold that heat a long time for use later. And of course, one of the problems with wind farms and solar plants is that normally they only can produce power for a few hours a day. So this increases the capacity to produce power at odd times.
And Rebecca, just quickly, I want to talk about the jobs that this is creating. Obviously, the Obama administration has made it a point to say that they will create jobs through clean energy. And you say this does do that.
It does. And actually, this is one area where we have still quite a bit of manufacturing happening in the U.S. In fact, the majority of components for some of these plants will be domestically made. So the more projects that get built, the more U.S. manufacturing jobs.